guys, welcome to Most Craved. I'm Jenna Bush with Legion of Leia.
I'm Silas Lesnick with ComingSoon.net.
And I'm William DeBiani with Crave Online. Hey, we got Shushka!
That's the only person who knows how to say her last name properly.
You're welcome.
Thank you.
We got Jen and Sylvia Shushka, and they have the Hellevator. Tell us about the Hellevator.
Oh my god, this looks awesome.
Oh, it's awesome, but I feel like you have to be sitting in our seats to enjoy it as much as we
do.
Yeah,
it's kind of like death proof that way.
Yeah, exactly. So we find three friends, and all they know is they're doing a survival horror game show. They don't know anything about it. And so they come into the lobby, and then they get in the Hellevator. And then we tell them to press a button, and then the interactive horror movie experience happens. But what they don't know is the first three floors, they have to go it alone.
Also, every episode has an individual narrative story, so you can't watch 1 week and be like, oh, I know how to beat the aliens, because you might never see those aliens again.
Yeah, absolutely. And they get harder every floor you go down. So the first floor is for $5,000, the second floor is $10,000, and the third floor is for $15,000. And if you survive, you get to go to the bonus level, which is the labyrinth, which is essentially like the last 15 minutes of every horror movie where everything comes to get you. And it's funny because some people are too chicken to go in the first one, and there's this one guy who's like, I'm too scared, I'll go in the second one. And so he put a black bag over his head, and then he woke up in a bathtub tied up, covered in leeches.
Oh my god!
Well, we have the Fear Factor team that's joined us for this, so you can imagine what we're getting away with.
So you get like the wholesale bugs.
Oh my gosh.
Best. We have two we're big Key and Peele fans. Uh-huh. And we have a salmon pink Goliath bird eater named Andre. And a much smaller one named Megan after, you know, their girlfriend boyfriend sketch. You know, they're so
Andre.
Awesome.
Andre.
Yeah. Megan, sit down.
Yeah, it kind of makes the tarantulas less scary though when you give them little voices. They're like, oh, I don't want to touch it. But now that it sounds like a girl version of Key and Peele.
Not for anyone but us. Everyone does not like the tarantulas.
Yeah. No, I get it. I used to name the bugs in my room as a little kid, so I wouldn't be scared of them. Totally get
really?
It.
Really?
Mm-hmm. Oh my god, mm-hmm. You're weird like us.
I am totally weird like you. Anybody who watches this show already knows that. But that's really, really cool. And so do you have clauses where you have to go through at least something?
Well, here's the thing. There are two people that were hoping to leave early because they were too scared. Like, they were saying things like, oh God, do I have to keep doing this? Please, can I go out? But
I can't do this alone. Where are my friends? What did you do to them? That sort of thing.
If you win a challenge, you're stuck. There's no way out. You're going through that labyrinth with whether you like it or not.
We can be highly motivating, too.
Yeah, and it's not just us. We have fear actors everywhere, and there's surveillance cameras everywhere. The guys are mics, so there's nowhere you can go that we're not watching you, which is kind of creepy.
No, it's fun.
Yeah, Jen and I are the masterminds. Like every girl, we have a lair. We sit on our lair, kind of like Jigsaw. We watch all the monitors.
And like Jigsaw, but better.
With more cleavage.
We're more Blumhousey.
So there's going to be a Jim and the Holograms crossover is what you're saying.
Oh, absolutely.
Actually, okay,
there's too many girls in the band. You can only take three.
We'll take the Misfits. There's three of them.
Oh, yeah. They should work for
and
us.
And their songs are better, so it's all good.
That is true.
The same way.
They have better hair.
But they're not outrageous. Truly,
not outrageous.
Truly outrageous.
They don't have the earrings, the Synergy earrings.
Synergy?
Got those.
I got guys, where did you, was Hellevator all your idea?
I want to say that, but it isn't.
You know what the funniest thing is? Jen was reading the press release for this show coming out, and she's like, damn, I wish I was doing that.
I shared it on my Facebook before I was even like, I was already considering like, maybe if I just like say I love every Blumhouse movie ever, which I do, maybe they'll hire me. Like, and I just kept pushing. And then our rep said, hey, do you think you'd ever do reality television? I was like, I don't know, fucking filmmaking. Oh. Oops, language.
You got one. That's the one.
That's the one. Beep. But filmmaking, you know, January, February is kind of slow. So we said, yeah, and we shot the pilot, and it was literally the best experience of our lives. And so I immediately thought, okay, don't think you're ever going to do that again. Just put it on the shelf of that was a great one-night stand, and you'll never do it again. And then we were back down here, and we ran into the casting director that brought us on. He's like, what are you guys doing here? And we're like, oh, we're just, you know, working and stuff. He's like, have you talked to production about the show? And I was like, no. And then we got called and they said, you know, there's a lot of great TV shows that go to pilot and, you know, a lot of them just never make it to television. That's not the case with Hellevator. And I was like shocked and I was like, you gotta be kidding me. It's going to series? Oh my God.
Yeah, I know. I'm still waiting for the real host to come. Thank God there's no horror triplets because they'd be like, all right, twins, hit the road. We're done.
I'm just thinking think Elvira and Dean Cain are going to be like, get out of here.
Yeah, it's so funny. There was a show that was getting developed, and because this one went, Bruce Campbell took our job.
Oh, my God. Well, then again,
Bruce Campbell and identical twins are kind of the same thing.
That's true.
They're pretty much the same.
Yeah. That job is like a horror version of King of the Geeks. I remember going in and pitching it together, and then I was online, and I was like, Bruce Bloody Campbell.
Yeah, that's a good guy to lose out to.
No, that's fine.
I like him.
He can take anything he wants of mine.
That's awesome. And when does it I can see it right here. Series premiere Wednesday at 8 on GSN.
That is a very nice Vanna White. Look at you.
Well done.
We're keeping you.
I can point to letters. Very talented. Really, really good at that.
Jenna, there's something else you really want to talk about this week.
Oh, yeah, there's some trailer that got released.
Was there? Jen, what's this? Jen, wait. Jen, who's this?
Oh,
not the actor, the character.
Oh my God. Okay, I know it's either.
She's never seen Star Wars.
There's two guys. I think either Luke Skywalker or Han Solo, and I literally do not know which one he is.
Well,
if I had to pick.
Yeah, pick
one of them was Mark Hamill.
The Joker.
No, Joker's not
Mark
in
Hamill
Star
was the
Wars.
Joker.
He was the best Joker.
He was the best Joker.
He was. Yeah. Oh, that's
so. Yes. Who is this?
You can do it.
It's going to be.
It was one or the other.
Luke?
Oh my God!
Is it really?
It's Han Solo.
No, it's not.
It is Han Solo.
Yeah.
Han Solo.
Yeah. Oh, I'm sorry.
Because he
sorry, everyone.
Because he was a loner.
Luke, I'm your father. When did you see Harrison Ford?
I didn't know if he maybe looked.
Are you younger? Like younger. A lot
he
of
was
people
talking.
Change.
Listen, they were on the phone. It's a futuristic society. Darth Vader was on his Bluetooth, about to kill Han Solo, just saying, incidentally, Luke, I'm your father. Okay, hold on.
That wasn't for you.
I've watched that movie.
Yeah.
You've been really down on Star Wars.
Yes, you have.
That's an exaggeration.
No.
I've been skeptical
about Star Wars.
You
haven't been necessarily positive. I'm curious what you thought of this.
I've been unenthusiastic about Star Wars because Star Wars has burned me many times in the past. I considered Star Wars to be like an ex-girlfriend who was like, it was kind of like, the sex was really good, but like the relationship itself was not rewarding. I'm hesitant to take Star Wars back.
Jen, this isn't a reference for the prequels. The first three weren't very well
received. And the animated movie, and the Ewoks movies, and the special editions, and the holiday special. If you look at it on average, most of the Star Wars feature-length films have sucked. So, I'm not exactly excited. But I saw this new trailer, and I'm going to tell you, they're doing a great job on these trailers. These are good, fun trailers. What I like about this new trailer in particular, the last trailer pretty much mostly just showed us slightly different versions of stuff we'd seen before. Here's a Stormtrooper armor, but now it's reflective. Ooh! here's a Star Destroyer. I know who that is. I haven't seen the movie. There's a Star Destroyer, but now it's flashed. Ooh! Here there's actually new stuff. There's like that big, tall, red robot guy, and he looks fun. And then there's another Death Star, so, you know.
Possibly. We don't know if it's a Death Star or not, and that's from the poster. So,
okay.
Because people are saying it's the Starkiller base, which is a converted ice planet.
Uh-huh.
But I don't particularly think that that's it, but I don't know. We heard what I believe is Lupita Nyong'o's voice, and she plays Maz Kanata, who I think was the character in the poster, but we don't know.
Uh-huh.
We know that if you really analyze the trailer, which I might have done last night, it's possible they're playing the Leia theme, like the over Rey and Finn at meeting Han Solo, which is really interesting, and flying the Millennium Falcon. It looks like the Millennium Falcon got hit. There are definitely clues. Anybody who's read all the books, I'll just push my glasses back up my nose now. Anyone who's read all the books, there are definitely references to specific things in here, and Kylo Ren's voice. So good.
Here's my question. What? Okay, we know Adam Driver is playing this new bad guy, Kylo Ren. He's got a Darth Vader-y mask.
Which he doesn't have on in one scene.
He's playing like, you know, he's saying, like, I will continue your mission, Darth Vader, to do the vague things you did with the Empire in the background of the movies.
Wow.
When all you really basically did was hunt Luke Skywalker, but now we're going to say you represented stuff. But anyway, when he takes off the mask, be honest, don't you think we're going to see Mark Hamill?
It's certainly a possibility, but I don't think so.
There's a distinct lack of Mark Hamill right here.
I got to say, I have been super pro Star Wars, all excited all this time, and now like this weekend I think is sort of where it like I'm still excited, but I am kind of worried. And one of the first things is this poster, which is like, why isn't this a painting? Why is this like a Photoshop job?
It should have been Drew Struzan.
Yeah,
it should have been
Drew Struzan. I don't get why it isn't. It looks like something they would sell at like Target at like the end of an aisle.
Yeah, I have to say I'm not loving the poster either.
I can't speak to the poster. If you know the Avengers posters, it's all about your contract and where you appear.
Exactly.
So, someone's agent negotiated her, him. He's got someone better than she does. And then we threw in some other
stuff. I love Carrie Fisher on this poster for two reasons. Uh-huh. One, the look on her face is saying, this again?
All right,
you
Carrie.
Want me back in this? Two, her hairstyle, Leia has a history of terrible hairstyles in this franchise. Her new one is Gary Oldman and Bram Stoker's Dracula.
Oh no.
And that's actually
once you see it,
amazing.
You can't unsee it.
It's true. But also, she's sad. Why is Leia sad? Why is the bottom half of Han's face sad? I'm concerned. I have anxiety.
Presumably, there'll be some sort of drama in the film that will affect them emotionally.
Perhaps there may be some drama.
I will say, too, like, in the trailer, there were two shots that, like, I suspect it's just, like, the mood I was in when I watched it. I don't know. But remembering this is a J.J. Abrams movie with the lens flare coming through, I don't like most J.J. Abrams movies. In fact, I actively hate his, like, Sergeant Into Darkness. And the idea that, like, oh, yeah, he's making this is not...
He's a fan of Star Wars.
That's so? Like, a lot of people are fans of things and they don't
but
like...
It's like you were saying, when you look at the average, like, I honestly don't like most of the movies he's made. And the other shot was just seeing Harrison Ford again, which did, like, it just reminded me, like, oh, I was really excited when Kingdom of the Crystal Skull came out.
Oh, yeah, that I'm not over. But it was really interesting because when we saw Han, he said that... Rey asked him, is this true? Like, there are a lot of stories. And he's like, no, it's true. The Jedi is the Force, all of it. Uh-huh. So we got a huge clue about the fact that this, the Force and Jedis are now sort of legend.
Okay.
It's I think been, that's pretty awesome.
I'm sorry. It's been 30 years since the events of the last.
So
that's like saying the Vietnam War is now a legend. Okay.
Yeah,
that's like saying,
were,
you know, the way it works in the Star Wars universe is the Sith became legendary between Revenge of the Sith and A New Hope.
Right.
Okay. The Sith became legendary because for centuries before the events of the prequel trilogy.
Nope. Not canon.
Not canon.
That's in the movies. They haven't been around for forever. There hasn't been a Sith in forever. They talk about that in the first film. There haven't been a Sith in a really, really long time. They say they're around, but they just think, where are they? But regardless, this is a futuristic society in which people communicate via holograms, and no one wrote anything down about a Star War.
No. The war is not a legend. The Jedi and the Force are legends.
The Jedi were in the Star War.
Yes,
but not necessarily.
The Jedi were leading one faction of the Star War.
It was only Luke and Obi-Wan, which who had been in hiding for so many years.
And Darth Vader, whom everyone knew was a Sith.
No, everyone assumed he wasn't because they said, oh, you're hokey religion. Oh, nobody really believes that he has the Force. And so
Force choked people. I think I believe him now.
Yeah, but they think
he used to Force choke people from another spaceship.
It wasn't online. People didn't see it. So the last time they knew all of the Jedi were destroyed in the Clone Wars, except that they weren't, but it's only a couple people and not everybody knew about him.
And you have the Empire doing all sorts of propaganda against.
The New Order
now. But the Rebellion would have done a lot of propaganda, too. A Jedi blew up the Death Star. You don't think they're going to mention that? There was a big coronation.
A Jedi didn't blow up the Death Star.
The Rebellion
a Padawan blew up the Death Star. I think that counts.
Well, I'm really excited about what Kathleen Kennedy is going to do with this series. Like, that woman and we're teamed with J.J. Abrams. I know... Maybe not. I fell asleep during the last Star Trek movie.
No, I didn't like that either.
But I woke up and there's a battle. And there was still a battle. I was like, oh, okay.
Well, it went on for a long time.
A lot of it. But I think Jurassic World is the number one movie in the world. Like, this is going to, like, topple that. And you're going to get, you're so lucky, fandom.
They aired the trailer during Monday Night Football as if there's anyone watching Monday Night Football who's going to go, oh, there's a new Star Wars coming out. The tickets were already crashed. The ticket sales were crashed. The internet.
Someone released
football.
It early. Yeah. I ended up. I was online. So I was kind of pissy by the time the trailer came out, but it changed my mind because I had to spend all that time online because they didn't announce that they released them early. But Kathleen Kennedy, like you said, she made a big push. She talked about how there are going to be more women, and having read all five Journalist The Force Awakens books. It's completely 50-50 women. It's really, really cool in all aspects. Like, it's almost jarring because we don't see it in TV shows or most movies.
Oh, yeah.
So it's really cool.
And yet you see it in real life a lot.
Yeah,
you
do look right now.
Wow. So you and I are outnumbered.
Yeah.
Yeah. All right. Neat.
A month's good company, though.
Like, who cares? Yeah, no, it's great. I just like, huh.
Good for us.
Weird. Right? And y'all are more successful than any of us, so there you go. You
oh, please.
For the next
you have your own show. It's called Hellevator.
Let's
we wait a minute. Show, I count one, right two.
You don't have a three elevator.
Of you. Three of you. You
I'll
can compete.
I'll
oh
do it.
My
as
gosh,
as long as I don't have
elevator.
To do too much running, I'm good.
Oh, I'll do it.
Yeah, you guys
I
are
can't
fantastic.
Do snakes. Anything but
why
snakes.
Are you telling
why
us
you tell
that?
Yeah, hell, you know there's going to be a lot of snakes.
There won't be snakes.
I just here's my greatest fear: insurance paperwork.
Oh.
So that's going to be, I'm curious to see what you're going to do with
it. I got an app for that. We can do it.
I don't know how TV friendly that would be. It'd just be you in the elevator, like, I can't come out.
That's what we called with adult situations. It's mostly just doing your taxes. You know, that's the reason why kids aren't supposed to watch those parental guidance videos. Hey, everybody, most cranked. Check out Hellevator. If there's a new Star Wars, you know, the one war everyone's kind of supporting. So you might want to check that out. And the wonderful Shosh guys.
Aw, Kusnim Saifan.
Kusnim Najwan Saifan.
Yes.
See you next week. May the force be with you.